was foreseen on program short presentation by the Serbian host about situation. So in 5 minutes I will try to introduce a forest sector as a probably interesting way away come and what we have here. But of course I fully agree with my colleague Vidas Jocnukis that ELO has tremendous input and tremendous support in the building of our organization's understanding of how to work in European Union, and it is very supportive to defend private ownership rights. Thank you very much indeed. And if speaking about Lithuania, of course, now a hot topic, it is a new financing period of European Union, new regulations, new regulations. And from forestry side, we expect that this year it will be adopted a European forest strategy, legally binding agreement on forestry. It is under as agenda on pipeline, and probably very soon it will be agreed one on another way. If not, it will be postponed to next period of negotiations. But if coming to our organizations, we already operate, we are existing more than 20 years. We celebrate this spring 20 years anniversary Lithuanian farmers, family farmers union also achieve this stage of anniversary, and we are happy to work in such a European environment. So what in my short presentation, just a bit how much, how many of us we are in Lithuania, what we are doing and what are problems or challenges we are facing, because today we are meeting with ministry representatives, with ministers, so I would like just to inform what is the hot topics here in Lithuania. So about Lithuanian forest, we have quite an abundant of land covered by forest. It is a 33% of total land, so it is a close to European average. In some countries it even less. So we have quite green country, not because only of agriculture, but also of forestry. And if to look to forest area and composition of different management regimes, so message which I would like to say, we have little bit more than 2 million hectares of forest in Lithuania. And we have around 250,000 landowners who own close to 1 million hectares of forest. Nowadays, and in private hands, it is over 800,000 hectares of forest. The remaining part, it is under the restitution or belongs to state. So it is very simple. 38, almost 39%, it is in private hands, and the remaining, it is a reserved for restitution, which is still continuing in 20 years period, or belongs to state. And it is a really important part of our economy. If forestry gives only 1% of the gross national product, but sector as total, gives about 4% to the national economy. And as, for instance, Lithuania, it is a fifth largest supplier of production to the IKEA concern. So it is a really quite well-developed industry in Lithuania. So we are not only exporting products, but also importing some part from Belarus, from Ukraine, from neighboring Latvia and Russia, because our industry needs more raw material, more industrial wood. And all the assortments which are exporting, so it is pulpwood, and in some extent it is also firewood and bilateral trade between organizations. Of course, having import, it is a meaning lower prices for forest owners for some products, and the market situation it is not such good as colleagues have in Germany, Austria, or even in Sweden. But anyway, forest owners can generate in incomes, and we are happy to have a good, well-developed industry in our country. And it is important and significant part of the whole economy, providing jobs for more than 50,000 people here. So if to look to the restitution process and how we come to the present situation, so nowadays those 38% of the private ownership in forest, long period of time it was totally state-owned in Soviet period. And here it is specific because in Lithuania people still use and know how to be an owners. And in other Soviet, post-Soviet countries, it is still this feeling disappear. But we have some specific, because bureaucrats come some part and still are active from this period. So we really have difficulties to protect private ownership rights and to explain that private ownership it should be respected. So it is obligations and also quite a lot of challenges here. If to look to the distribution of ownership, it is similar to France, but of course we do not have such big landlords with 100,000, tens of thousands of hectares of forest. There are smaller, the biggest owner, he owns about 10,000 hectares of forest, but it's industrial group. Another private forest have about 1,800 or so, but there are very few. Majority it is 1 to 3 hectares of forest, and mean forest holding size it is 3.4. hectares of forest altogether. So it is many people are working here, and just to show that sector is important, and it is generate about 1 billion liters per annum of incomes from both private and state forest sector. And if to look to challenges we are facing, we are small, fragmented, ownership restitution, it is not over yet. And cooperation, that is difficult. People still remember this collectivization period, collecting farms from Soviet period, and do not keen to cooperate even in agriculture. We have a vice chairman of Chamber of Agriculture here, Sigitas Dimaitis. So they are struggling to promote cooperation in agriculture already for 2 decades, and difficult is this process going. And forestry is under the Ministry of Environment in Lithuania, and agriculture under the Ministry of Agriculture, so it creates additional problems, because those who are responsible for money do not responsible for forestry, and those who are responsible for the forest policy do not responsible for cooperation, for rural development, so it is a challenge to be and to merge efforts here. Now, and many forest owners just try to supply firewood from the forest for own needs or for recreation, but you remember last year I talked about hunting issue. This year, Parliament tried to adopt amendments, changes in law, that this law, which contradicts to our constitution already 8 years, will be changed. Parliamentarians do not succeed. It was voting, it was different spectaculars going on, but in, finally we have the same law which contradicts our constitution, what is stated by our constitutional code, that it is not correspond to constitution, but it's still valid after 8 years of such a statement made by law constitutional court. And thank for your law, for support papers, but it don't work, don't help even. Yeah, so we have electric power organizations who actually push additional amendments in the Forest Act, and now they make amendments that electrical power organization can change land use destination, can cut forest where they plan to build new electricity lines, even do not asking owner and do not paying any compensation. Such a reality of a recent half an year. So, but we have very, very powerful now and very clever Minister of Environment, who is a leader of one political party. He will be here at 11 o'clock, I expect. So he is doing a lot of changes, but main focus of him, he's an architect, to change all whole system of territory planning legislation. Because now if you want to build something, you need at least 2 years for negotiation with bureaucrats before you start actual planning. So it is quite long. So not taking your time, our organization have strategic goals with support with ELO. We're trying to fulfill and doing quite successfully. And I think that you'll have questions later because we're a little bit short in time. So thank you for possibility to present very shortly the sector. And once again, thank for ELO for supporting us.